cause for which we are hoping to address it through our film. And let me just take you through the journey of the film as to how it all began. Is she here? Okay. So last year around this time, I met Usha ji, and she's been working on this subject since a very long time. And it was something that has, I think all of us have had read about it and seen it, and nobody was talking about it. So the reason that we wanted to make this film, she said something very, that resonates with me personally. There are two people that shape up a child. One is the parent and the other is the guru. So we need to address guru being the teacher. And since the foundation is doing so much work with schools, it's very important that we address both these communities, the people, because children look up to their teachers. So we decided, but there were issues that the foundation was facing while doing field work. The issues were that the schools were not very receptive, were not very, they would want to guard the reputation of the school. They wouldn't want to get involved with the personal aspects of a child. So how do we address that? So we decided that we need, so that's how the story all emerged, that we need to make something that is ideal for the world to see. That is something that a stand, that a principal and a teacher should take while something like this goes on in school. Child is abused. Would you want to get involved in that person's life, or would you want to just brush your hands off? So we decided we want to show that yes, they do take a stand. They do get involved. So that's what we decided. That's how the story came through. And then there was another issue that they were facing, the foundation was facing, through their field research work, was parents don't have time for their kids. So that's something else that we've addressed in the film. That we decided that if the child knows that he can go and talk up to his parent about this issue and not feel embarrassed or ashamed, feel that confidence of actually speaking out and speaking up. So these are the things that the foundation was constantly facing in their field work. So that's how then the story emerged, that we decided to bring in this a boy and a girl, and also address at the heart of the film rejuvenative, universal powers of friendship, as to how even kids help each other. They understand, they sense that something is not right with their friend. So that's how they pick up. And sometimes a kid can also help a kid speak up. So that's how we've also tried to bring that message through in the film also. The power, the rejuvenative power of speaking up. So that's what we are doing through this film. So we began this entire journey in January, and of scripting and pre-production, and we went into production in March, April, and May, and then when Revati ji came on, it added the entire magic, and we're so, so grateful to have you, ma'am. Really, it was just wonderful to have you. And so this is something that the entire team that came on board came on passionately for the cause. So that's what the journey has been. And we then decided that the film got ready by August, and then that's when we decided that let's wait for the right time to release. Nothing as opportune as the 14th of... Nothing as opportune as the 14th of November being Children's Day, and 19th November being the World Day of Protection of Children Against Sexual Abuse.
Thank you. Message of good touch, bad touch to even the more remote corners of this country.
A very good evening to all of you, Usha ji, Pankaja madam, and all the dignitaries here. Today I'm happy to be here today at this launch of trailer, because it's dealing with a very important, very sensitive topic, which is the need of the hour. In fact, first I would like to appreciate the efforts of USK Foundation, now Gravitas, because it has been working relentlessly into different fields, teaching girls self-defense, then free checkups, eye checkups, and now into good touch, bad touch. They've already conducted a lot of camps in schools, and this is which is the need of the hour. I have this alarming figure with me that 53% of children between the age of 5 and 12 are being sexually abused today. That is more than half of the children who are young, who are small, who are innocent, are being abused, and their lives are being tortured by these nightmares. So this is high time that we stand up and we make everyone aware of this existing issue. In fact, another alarming figure is that out of this 53% children who are abused, there are more guys or children or boys who are being abused. Around 57 boys are abused, wherein abuse among girls is 42%. So people should know that it's not only girls, but boys are also being abused. And the best way I feel is creating awareness by interpersonal contacts, contacting children, contacting their parents, contacting the schools, and even ZP schools and teachers. And the best medium can definitely be such films like Udne Do. We have another mediums like social media, but since this is involving children and a sensitive issue, the best way is through these kind of camps or these kind of movies, that children can be made aware of this problem. Mostly these sexual abusers, these criminals, are people whom the families know very well or trust a lot. 50% of these abusers are your own trusted people. So first thing, people need to be made aware that such things exist and are happening, because in remote areas, people are not even aware at times. Once they are aware, there has to be a conducive environment wherein your children and parents both should have a very friendly dialogue regarding this. In a country, and especially in three-tier cities and villages, where even speaking about sex is a taboo, so this knowledge, giving this knowledge, is very important. And finally, yes, you have to have prompt actions. Like you would be knowing under POSH, now even a 12-15-year-old case wherein child has been abused and now he is grown up, he can also put in a complaint, and it needs to be resolved within 2 months. So these are some positive steps which are being taken to be as a deterrent against this kind of heinous crime. But there are various other measures we need to take care of, like this movie which has been created by Madam's NGOs, like government bodies and NGOs and people coming together for creating this environment and a platform where these things can be discussed openly. And as a society, we should come in the forefront to combat this kind of a disease which is caught up. So it has to be a joint effort, and we have to just kill it any which ways we can, I feel.
Thank you, Amitaji. I love that. It has to be not just a joint, but a societal effort. And I'd like to ask Pankaja ji, you know, we spoke about social media, we spoke about opening up more. What are your thoughts on starting a campaign, maybe like the Pulse Polio campaign or the Hum Do Hamare Do campaign? Do you think that would help spread this message, or your thoughts on it?
I think the campaign has already begun. People have started talking about it. As Amruta ji mentioned, that 53% of the children are exposed to this kind of hideous scenario. But there is always law, there is always protection given to them. Only thing is, they are too young to understand good touch and bad touch. Now how Usha Kakadeji took initiative, and she made this film, her foundation made this film, and she's going with her NGO going to schools and making them understand. Even we in our curriculum are in kind of incorporating these things, where we are making people, kids, teachers aware, taking their training, making these kids aware. But only thing is that they are so gentle, making them understand everything around them is dirty or bad. More than providing them with knowledge, we should provide them with protection. And we should make their parents and teachers aware that if there is something like this, you should open up and speak about it, rather than bothering about the image of the organization or image of the family. Because all this while, all these decades, people have kept quiet just because of that false thing that their image and their family name gets spoiled. So they have kind of suppressed the desire of getting protection and getting their rights, getting justice there. So that has changed now. I feel even parents are becoming very vocal about it. They are demanding protection, they are demanding justice. And now there are so many drives now, everybody on the social media, we were just discussing inside, that the women also are talking about injustice happened to them at workplace and all. And they are getting justice. And now even in our country, if a minor is getting raped or brutally raped, the conviction rate is going higher every day, and there is a death sentence for that if the man has been raped. So this has been taken care by government, by bureaucracy, and also by society. So this common platform has to be provided, and we are quite doing well, but these numbers quite discouraging, and that they have to change. But it's not only in our country, it's everywhere. This sick behavior has to be addressed, and they have to be punished.
Thank you, ma'am. Definitely a global issue, and it's time to start shaming the perpetrators, not the victims. Yeah. Of course, there is social media, but I think one of the strongest mediums is film. I know you've had many cinematic outings on serious subjects. Two-pronged question to you. Your experience with this film, and definitely your thoughts on the subject itself. Revati ji.
Namaste. And I really have to appreciate USK Foundation for giving Aarti the space to make such a film, very, very sensitively made. And when I read the script the very first time, I was worried whether she will be able to do what she has actually written. And we spoke about it, how much can you talk about it? Because unless certain things are said, it really makes no sense. मैं बार बार बोलती हूँ कि मेरे दादाजी ने मुझे स्वतंत्रता दी है टू डू व्हाट आई वांट टू डू इन दिस कंट्री हैज गिवन मी फ्रीडम अब मैं बच्चों के लिए मैं क्या दे रही हूँ कैसी दुनिया दे रही हूँ एंड इट्स सो सैड दे हैव सेड मोस्ट ऑफ द थिंग्स सो इट इज़ अ वेरी सैड एस्पेक्ट एंड आई फील दैट मूवीज इज अ मीडियम दैट रियली हेल्प्स दैट most people remember a good moment and whatever I've seen of Udne Do, I am definite that this film will leave a mark And the most important people to be addressed are the parents and the institutional heads, teachers. क्योंकि ये जो यू नो सोसाइटी में जो रिड्रेसल सिस्टम चाहिए दैट इज़ द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग. इट्स नॉट द चिल्ड्रन, इट्स अबाउट यू नो मेकिंग एवरी पेरेंट अवेयर कि थोड़ा कुछ बिहेवियरल चेंज हो, थोड़ा सा भी. वी नीड टू जस्ट टेक नोटिस. वी नीड टू नो आवर चिल्ड्रन वेल, teachers and institutions, because most institutions have a habit of putting these things under the carpet because they don't want a bad name. So that is where all institutional heads and all the people, you know, who are sponsors to these institutions, all the schools, colleges, everybody should be addressed, and this film addresses them. And I think that is very important, to tell them that to make a better country, to give something to our children. I mean, it's not about property, it's not about cars, it's not about houses, it's not about gold, it's not about the money in the bank. We need to give them a safer world to live in so that they can fly with their dreams. And I love the title, Aarti, Udne Do. Yes, we need to give them the wings to be able to do what they want to do. And films definitely is a very powerful media, and Aarti has done a great job of that. Yeah.
Thank you, Revati ji. Before we move ahead, we've been joined by our fabulous style and fashion guru. Usha ji, may I request you to felicitate him before we move on, please. And also, Aarti, we need to felicitate you as well. So I'm going to request you to come up here. Of course, Manish needs no introduction. Style and fashion guru to the stars. And Usha ji also to please, to Aarti. Congratulations, it is a beautiful film. I'll take off from there, Revati ji, on, you know, educating people in all walks of life. So my next question is to you, Nilesh ji. Do you think it's an important CSR initiative for a company like Reliance, this particular topic especially?
Yes, so this topic, I'm a father of a two-year-old child, and when I look at her, the vision of what she looks up to around people, she looks at us with trust. So parents, all the acquaintances, neighbors, or even the security wala in the building, she looks at everybody with so much of trust, the innocence that she is carrying. She's not taught to disrespect people or even look at them with suspicion, and that's not something we as parents even would think of teaching her. So as Pankajaji said, if we want to teach children, there is a danger that they would start to look at the world as a dark place, which is something that we don't really want to do. So this particular movie, which puts the emphasis on the dialogue between the children and the parents, because if a child is abused, whom would he go to? He or she would go to either her parents or to the teachers, because they are the closest people in her or his ecosystem. So as Reliance organization, we have a lot of CSR initiatives. One of them is Reliance Foundation, which is headed by our Madam Neeta Ambani. So we work very closely with different schools in rural areas. So not only the educational system, but even the value system is something that we try to impart. And it's really an important problem area which we should tackle.
Thank you so much. Aarti, I know you've spoken, but it's a very serious topic. Your inspiration behind it, what made you take on the film?
So I'm going to be repeating myself, but it all began last year around this time when I met Usha ji. And it so happened that I got to know that she's been working so aggressively on this cause of good touch and bad touch. And these are simple words. These are words that kids understand. You can't say child sexual abuse. You'll confuse the child. So it's that was wonderful. That was a new knowledge for me. And when we interacted a bit, I got to know that the foundation is having difficulties to get through to schools, to get through to parents. So, you know, and that is what we decided, that we will address all that in the film. And we will address that if kids want to share something with each other, or they want to help each other rejuvenate by the powers of speaking up. So that is something that we want to do. So this whole journey started from January, when we scripted and we shot in the months of March, April, and when we shot with Revathi ji, and when she came on board, it was fully magic for the film. We wanted her charm, her compassion, and yet her power of the personality to come into the principal that gives that motivation for us that this is the figure that we want to be. So that's how it happened. And then when we were in discussions, we realized that the opportune time to release is between this 14th November, which is the Children's Day, and 19th November, which is World Day of Protection for Children Against Sexual Abuse. So that's when we decided that nothing more opportune than that, and create that cause, make that cause reach out to world over, basically. So, I mean, it's high time that we be that agent of change, and our children deserve better. And Udnedu is that agent of change.
Thank you so much, Aditya. Very well said. Manish, it's really lovely to have you here with us. And I know you know about the foundation's work. Your thoughts on this film? It's such an important topic, good touch, bad touch for children. And the foundation's effort working tirelessly towards this cause. Your thoughts on it?
Greeting everyone. I'm so sorry for being late. I've been hectic with work. And I've actually come in my work clothes. I just quickly wore this blazer in the car. And I know Usha ji, I think I've known her since about 3 years now. And I do know of her passion for lots and lots of things. It's beyond clothes. And she is a person of four causes. And in fact, we've been speaking about one as well. And so she is somebody who feels for these things. And I think that is the first germ of this whole, the whole organization that's come up and the whole foundation. And she did speak to me that she was doing something like that. And I think which is so good is that today we all are actually speaking all of these things, which probably a few years back we didn't. And I think it's like you said, that it is so true that not to scare a child and give them this whole dark vision, but add a lot of positivity and add a lot of faith and hope in humanity as well. And also speak about that there is a good touch as well. And then, yes, there is a bad touch. And I think it's the bad touch topic that we generally avoided speaking. And I think now it's so good whether you started doing so. But it's that right balance, because, you really cannot even scare the child and, give them a complete wrong impression. And they start seeing everything which is really wrong. So I think a movie like this and with credible names like Revathi and so many of you all involved in it, it is... movies like these and foundations like this, which I think will get a lot more notice, get people to notice and actually give them the strength to speak. And I think there are so many topics that I'm not a parent as yet, but I have my nephews and nieces and who are very friendly to me. And I think maybe with an uncle, it's easier to speak than maybe with your actual father or your mother. And I think it's very important for parents to not be paranoid. And, I give that paranoia to their kids, but also to be, of course, protective and give them the right, say the things at the right time. That's also very important. And I think it's really, really good that there are these kind of films coming up, foundations coming up, which is supporting all of this. And there's a general awareness, and which is absolutely great.
That's so beautifully said, the balance, Manish, that is so, so important. Usha ji, main aapse puchna chahungi, you're working so tirelessly in so many causes. Aapki prerna kya hai? Kaun hai? Aap batayenge hame.
Actually, sabse pehle main media ki maafi mangna chahti hu because bahut late program hua. I'm so sorry. Main jin logon se milti hu aur jo unse mujhe seekhne ke liye milta hai, chahe wo chhota ho, chahe wo bada ho, main unko apna guru manti hu. और मुझे आप लोगों से एक चीज़ यहाँ पे बहुत बताना ज़रूरी लग रही है कि जब मैं पुणे में मेरी बड़ी गाड़ी आलीशान गाड़ी में बैठ के किधर तो जा रही थी और सिग्नल में मेरी गाड़ी रुक गई. जब मेरी गाड़ी सिग्नल पे रुक गई और तब हमने देखा कि एक 80 इयर्स की ग्रैंड मदर एक चाइल्ड को लेके वहाँ पे खड़ी है और उसके बाजू में एक बेगर है जो भीख मांग रहा है. बहुत सारी गाड़ियाँ आती है जाती है, वो क्रॉस करने की कोशिश कर रही है रोड पर, वो क्रॉस नहीं कर पा रही है. हम सब गाड़ी में बैठ के देख रहे, एक दूसरे की तरफ देख रहे और वो बहुत टाइम से कोशिश कर रही है. वो बेगर ने अपना कटोरा नीचे रखा और उसको रास्ता क्रॉस करने को दिया. तो तो वो बेगर से भी कुछ मुझे सीखने को मिला तो मैं उसको भी अपना गुरु मानूंगी। तो यही मैं प्रेरणा सबसे लेती हूँ।
क्या बात है, बहुत खूब। कुछ सवाल आई एम श्योर ऑडियंसेस करना चाहेंगे, बट बिफोर दैट दो और लोग हैं जिन्हें हम, तीन लोग हैं जिन्हें हम फेलिसिटेट करना चाहेंगे। वी हैव टू ऑफ द स्टार्स विद अस टुडे, द चाइल्ड स्टार्स, कैन वी हैव यू गाइस अप फ्रंट? उन्हें फेलिसिटेट करेंगे प्लीज। उषा जी, तालियां बज सकती हैं सबके लिए। हाय, वेयर इज अनाया, इज शी हियर एज वेल? Thank you so much for being here with us, and we have one other fan moment for me. Divya, you're here as well. Could we please have you up front and felicitate you with this wonderful pot? Laiga, will you carry a pot home with you? Can we give you one? Please take this. Ek aur lai. Divya, please come up front. Thank you so much for being here with us. You know what, Adi, you should sit here, I think, for this. If there are any questions you'd like to ask the panelists, please let me know. Aapke paas ek, hanji, mic. Is there separate ones for audiences? Okay, I'm going to give this one. Will you share one mic between us? Can someone help me with the mics? Aapko de? Can you pass it between you guys?
Yeah, good evening. The trailer is quite beautiful and quite appealing. My question is to Amrita ji and Pankaja ji. Awareness definitely is what actually is needed, and awareness ho raha hai. But don't you feel so ki school is the place where, you know, it has to be more awareness hona chahiye, aur hamare system mein is tarah se kuch hona chahiye ki every month ya every, you know, 15 days there should be something, as we were talking about good touch, bad touch, not only ke ek bar aapne kiya 6 mahine mein, are there anything like which is there by law ki hum hamare institution mein school jaisi jagah par ek 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 particular aise classes rahe 15 din ya har week mein ho, jisse, you know, you get more kind of an awareness on this thing.
Is the question to somebody particular or anyone?
Amrita ji or Pankaja ji, like.
So other than what legally is happening, that side should handle. But yeah, I can tell you, if you just consider Mumbai, and I have been speaking to the BMC commissioner, he has covered 99% of schools of BMC through these kind of monthly programs, in which NGOs volunteer, or in-house they have teachers being trained now, wherein they are made aware of good touch, bad touch, and how to deal with this. As you know, because of this kind of awareness, earlier in 2014, around 34,000 cases were registered. 2016, that has come up to 36,000. That doesn't mean that only awareness will help, as we discussed. We need to have stringent actions, more awareness programs, and thirdly, a deterrent by way of strict laws, like Pankaja ji said, any girl or a child raped below the age of 12 years, the person can be hanged to death. So these kind of deterrents are very important. And other than that, are you planning to have something in curriculum of children that,
yeah, something like compulsory, like we have periods actually, you know, matlab ki to particular weekly or 15 days mein,
basically there is act in place, there is act for child rights safety, there is law in place, but the school is not the only place where child is exposed to these kind of things. But that is why school is one of the areas where we can teach them good touch and bad touch. From the very first sentence I said, I don't want to malign their mind about everyone around them, but they should, as Manish also very correctly said, they should know there is good touch. This touch is indicating love, this touch is indicating something wrong, but there are two tender, their age is too tender, so their school will educate them about certain things. At home, parents are the whole and sole authority and responsibility for their children and their life, and they are too busy. Though they are busy, we are there busy for providing our kids only, but at the same time we should also draw a line. We understand expression of our children. I am so busy, If I go home and I see my son's face is not normal, I immediately understand there is something wrong with him, his school, his friends, anything. So one should have communication with, first of all, अपने बच्चों के साथ, अपने माँ बाप के साथ तो बात करो, बाद में दुनिया आती है, बाद में गवर्नमेंट आती है, बाद में पुलिस आती है. मैं यही विश करती हूँ कि किसी को उस लेवल पे जाने की जरूरत ही ना पड़े, कोई पुलिस स्टेशन में ही ना जाए, ऐसा उसके साथ कुछ हो नहीं. पर अगर हुआ है तो उसको शर्म के वजह से, फैमिली नेम के वजह से, डोंट सप्रेस इट, ओपन अबाउट इट, गो टू द पुलिस, गो टू द स्कूल, कंप्लेन अबाउट इट, एंड देयर एवरी एक्ट इज इन प्लेस. आपके लिए हर कायदा बना हुआ है, बस उसका हम कायदे को यूज करते नहीं थे इतने साल, अभी कर रहे हैं. Women are doing, children are doing, so they are most welcome, and we are changing also the laws. अभी बहुत सारे ऐसे पिछले decade में घटनाएं हुई. I'm purposely speaking in both the languages because sometimes I can't speak with that heart in English because I have to think in my own language. But जब बहुत सारी घटनाएं पिछले decade में हुई जिसमें minors को attack किया गया, बच्चों को attack किया गया और rape, उनको मार दिया गया, क्योंकि अगर rape के बारे में केसेस हो रहे हैं तो उनका विटनेस नहीं होने की वजह से दे कैन नॉट सीक जस्टिस. तो इसीलिए उनके साथ ब्रूटली घटनाएं हुई. इसलिए अभी सरकार ने, केंद्र सरकार ने ये नया कायदा लाया कि अगर 12 साल के बच्चे से नीचे के बच्चे के साथ ऐसे घटना होती है तो उसके लिए डेथ सेंटेंस किया है, विच इज़ वेरी गुड डिसीजन इन अ वे, बिकॉज इट विल काइंड ऑफ एक फियर फैक्टर भी होना चाहिए लोगों के बीच में. तो बच्चों को ज्यादा अटैक करते हैं बिकॉज दे कैन स्पीक, दे डोंट अंडरस्टैंड. सो दैट इज व्हाई वी हैव टू मेक देम अंडरस्टैंड, वी हैव टू ऑब्जर्व आवर ओन किड्स एंड आवर ओन सोसाइटी.
जैसे अमृता जी ने बताया था कि ऐसे कुछ केसेस होते हैं जहां पर मे बी लाइक 15 साल पहले भी है, बट देन नाउ देयर इज अ कमिटी लाइक इट्स गोइंग टू टेक एक्शन विद इन 2 मंथ्स. पिछले मतलब कुछ पिछले कुछ दिनों में हम मी टू मूवमेंट की बात कर रहे थे एक्चुअली. तो अगर वहां पर उस तरह का यही कानून लागू हो जाए, या इज देयर एनी पर्टिकुलर थिंग,
ये कानून सबके लिए लागू है, मी टू के लिए है या नहीं है ऐसा नहीं, सबके लिए है. महिला आयोग है, सरकार है, पुलिस है, कायदा है, ब्यूरोक्रेसी है, ये सबके लिए लागू है. बस अभी इसके बारे में बात हो रही है तो लोग उसमें सोचने लगे हैं. ये पहले भी था, आज भी है और कल भी रहेगा. बस इसके बारे में बोल्डनेस आ गया है, लोग अपना एक्सप्रेस कर रहे हैं अपने साथ हुआ अन्याय. हम भी अगर कोई लड़की के साथ कुछ गलत होता है और बात करती है तो आपने देखा इवन मी टू में वो लड़कियों को कितना स्ट्रगल करना पड़ा अपनी बात रखने के लिए और उसमें उनको कितना क्रिटिसिज्म फेस करना पड़ा. तो पहले लड़की खुद के बारे में बात करती है, उसके साथ कुछ गलत हो गया तो हम उसको रिस्पेक्ट करें. अगर वो गलत है तो गलत है, वो सही है तो उसको जस्टिस मिलना चाहिए. पर उसको हम बोल उसको ही बदनाम करने की एक एटीट्यूड जो सोसाइटी में है, इफ शी स्पीक्स अबाउट समथिंग हैपन टू हर, विच इज चेंजिंग. आई होप इट चेंजेस फास्टर देन एवर. And this will give them protection. ये committee एक माध्यम है, but ultimately it goes to the law only.
Usha, I'll add up to this. Under POSCO Act, you can always go online on the child website, and even a child can put in a complaint. It's pitotal. So, and as I said, 15 साल बाद भी उन्होंने complaint किया तो it will be taken into account and justice will be delivered.
उषा जी,
एक्चुअली यू नो द प्रेस, आई एम रिक्वेस्टिंग यू टू गिव द माइक बैक टू द हैंडलर्स प्लीज, सो वी कैन गो इन एन ऑर्डरली फैशन. ज़रीन, यू हैड अ क्वेश्चन फॉर उषा जी, प्लीज कैन वी गिव द माइक टू ज़रीन प्लीज, एंड आई विल कम बैक टू यू. Can you give the mic to Zareen, please? And the ladies there need a mic for. Okay, let's finish. I think we should. No, we could let you finish this question. No problem at all.
But I think I just mentioned when I came in as well as that it's a very, very sensitive and a thin balance, because it's like, you know, you have to also give a lot of positivity, you have to show a very good side to an upcoming child, and it cannot be projected as dark. But of course, with that, there's this whole thin balance that the parents have to first start at home, of saying that, you know, and making them comfortable that if there is ever something that happens to you, God forbid, do come to us first. And don't fear it. Fear anything or anyone. So I think that whole, I think the balance coming from the parents and upbringing is the most important thing. And like you mentioned, that in school, whether there should be a kind of knowledge given. I think at the right age for the you know, for the children to adapt it. And I'm sure there is a program. And like you all mentioned, that there are apps for protection. And so all of that. So I think that is being implemented. But I think it all starts at home. I think most importantly, it is parental guidance as well as comforting that is most important.
Totally agree with you. I have a 12-year boys. Sorry, we have a question. I have a 12-year-old actually, and I think we started this conversation at home. Zareen, you've been waiting to ask Usha ji a question for some time. This will be the last question. I'm so sorry, ladies and gentlemen of the press.
Namaste, aap sabhi ko, and good evening. Usha ji, main ye sawal aapse puchna chahti hoon. जो हमारी महिलाएं हैं जो पहली बार माँ बनती हैं या जो हमारी युवा माएँ हैं वो ये जागरूकता अपने बच्चों में किस तरीके से फैला सकती है, वो उनको किस तरीके से जागरूक कर सकती है कि ये सही स्पर्श है, ये गलत स्पर्श है, ये गुड टच है, ये बैड टच है, एक माँ अपने बच्चे को किस तरीके से वो समझा सके, बिकॉज यू नो इट्स नॉट वेरी ईजी टू पुट इट अप, ये इतना आसान नहीं होता बच्चों को समझाना, तो आप किस तरीके से वो माओं को मैसेज देना चाहेंगी कि वो किस तरीके से अपने बच्चों को इस बारे में समझा सके? थैंक यू.
मुझे लगता है कि इसीलिए हमने ये गुड टच बैड टच का सेशन स्टार्ट किया है कि छोटे बच्चों को आप यू नो जब हम ये सेशन एक्सपर्ट टीम के साथ स्कूल में करते हैं तो बच्चों को हम लोग ये सिखाते हैं तो बच्चे इतना क्वेश्चन हमसे पूछते हैं, छोटे छोटे बच्चे, तो क्या हम अपने मम्मी पापा से नहाए क्या नहीं नहाए, इतने सारे क्वेश्चन पूछते हैं जिसका जवाब हमें देने भी मुश्किल हो जाता है, पर उसी समय हमको जो सही लगता है कि नहीं यू नो जहाँ पे बैड टच होता है वहाँ पे नहीं, बाकी हर जगह पे आप बहुत मुश्किल होता है, पर हम उसको समझाते हैं, सिखाते हैं. एंड मुझे लगता है कि थोड़े बच्चे बड़े होने के साथ अब पेरेंट्स को बच्चों के साथ खुलकर बात करनी चाहिए, उनके साथ टाइम बिताना चाहिए, उनके साथ थोड़ा सा वक्त अगर देते हैं तो एक वो आजकल क्या हो रहा है, पेरेंट्स और बच्चों के बीच में थोड़ा संवाद कम पड़ रहा है, इसीलिए भी थोड़ा ज़्यादा ये चीज़ें अभी हो रही है ऐसे मुझे लगता है, और हम इसके लिए ये प्रयास कर रहे हैं और अभी तक हमारे 3 लाख बच्चे कम्प्लीट हुए, इसके बच्चों का फ़ायदा हुआ है, और अगले साल में हमारे 6 लाख बच्चे कंप्लीट होंगे, और इसीलिए हमको ऐसे लगा कि इतने में ये काफ़ी नहीं है, इसीलिए हमने ये फिल्म का लॉन्च किया और आरती जी को रिक्वेस्ट की कि अच्छा से अच्छा हम लोग इसको कैसे पहुंचा सकते हैं, अवेयरनेस इसका कितना ज़्यादा कर सकते हैं, और हमें बहुत उसका बच्चों को फ़ायदा हो रहा है ये हमको दिख रहा है.
थैंक यू
एंड
देखिए कहीं पर भी ये चीज़ें ना हो यही हमारा प्रयास है, पर ये करने वाली चीज़ें भी हमारे सोसाइटी की है और भुगतने वाले भी सोसाइटी के हैं, हम भी सोसाइटी के, हम कोई बाहर के नहीं है, हम नहीं चाहते ऐसी घटनाएं हो, पर ब्रूटल रेप स्पेशली रेप एंड मर्डर हैड बिकम अ वेरी बिग थिंग इन बिटवीन एंड इट वॉज डिस्कस्ड ऑल्सो, फिर लोगों के कैंडल मार्च होने लगे, लोगों के उसके बारे में रिएक्शंस होने लगे, तो उसके लिए फास्ट ट्रैक कोर्ट ये एक बहुत बड़ा इम्पॉर्टेंट डिसीजन सरकार ने लिया है. दूसरी बात यह है कि इसमें जो मोस्टली हमने जो देखा जो सर्वे हुआ है जिसमें माइनर गर्ल्स हैं, इसीलिए उसके स्ट्रेंथ जो उनको शिक्षा करनी चाहिए वो ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा कड़ी हो, यह हमारा निर्णय है. और सरकार में, महाराष्ट्र सरकार में हमने एक निर्णय लिया है, सीएम सर देवेंद्र जी और हमने, हमारे डिपार्टमेंट ने, क्योंकि होम डिपार्टमेंट की वजह से सर के पास वो केसेस जाते हैं और हम सिर्फ उसका काउंसिलिंग और उनका रिहैबिलिटेशन हम देखते हैं, तो हमने जॉइंटली एक डिसीजन लिया है जिसमें एसिड विक्टिम्स है, रेप विक्टिम्स है, उनको रिहैब करने के लिए पहले 1 लाख रुपए खर्चा जाता था, उनको मैक्सिमम 3 लाख रुपए मिलते थे, अभी हम उनको 10 लाख रुपए दे रहे हैं और उसकी स्कीम का नाम मनोधैर्य है। तो वी वॉन्ट देम टू ट्रीट इट एज एक्सीडेंट एंड स्टार्ट लिविंग लाइफ अगेन, नॉट टू एंड देयर लाइफ, एंड देन ऑफकोर्स देर इज होम मिनिस्ट्री टू डू अ राइट चार्ज शीट फॉर देम एंड देर इज जुडिशरी टू टेक ड्यू एक्शन अगेंस्ट देम।
थैंक यू मैम। आज की शाम, एक सेकंड, आज की शाम बच्चों के नाम है एंड द अदर चाइल्ड आर्टिस्ट इज ऑल्सो हियर, आफ्टर विच आप थैंक यू कह सकती हैं सबको। अनाया, कैन वी हैव यू अप हियर प्लीज, अब बाद में बात कर सकते हैं वन ऑन वन।
मनीष,
No, actually, the thing is that good touch and bad touch is, of course, for women, for men, for everybody. But it's about, when we speak about children, that's where it starts. And a child at times, someone older, like say you and me, I'm much older, of course, but we can handle it, you can handle it. You would probably know what to do, you will understand it, you will understand an intent. But with a child, they are a little more unaware. And so the whole idea is to start with the children. And of course, when the children get aware, as an adult, they are far more aware and they get aware. So that's the whole thing. So I think till now what's been happening is, it's when you kind of come to school, like your 10th standard, you come to higher class, or you come into college, you interact with friends and you start understanding a lot of things, and that's when you catch on. But as a child, you're unaware. And a lot of abuse that happens during that time, and the child suffers, probably sometimes for life, mentally. And mental illness is also something that people started talking now about. But for years, there's been a mental illness and no one's spoken about it. And as a parent, they would wonder what's wrong with their child. But it could ruin someone's, a child's life completely. You know, so that is where it starts. And it goes on to an awareness. So as an adult, you're much more aware and much more better equipped mentally as well to deal with it.
Thank you, Manish. Thank you, members of the press. I'm really going to have to cut it short. I'm so sorry. Revati, would you like to add something? You have the mic in your hand, so yeah. Before.
I just wanted to say, I have a 5-year-old daughter and very late in my life. So it is very tough to understand how to say, what to say. And recently in her school, which is pre-primary, you know, there was just thing that when you feel, because all children, they have this sixth sense that something is not right. So we need to just tell them, as parents, that we need to tell them, when you feel scared about something, when there is something which is not good, come running and tell. You know, don't be scared. So ghar mein jab kuch, you know, even it starts with ek jam bottle le li, wo tod diya. Are kyu toda? What's this thing, that thing? And, you know, whole lot of shouting. They get scared. Their fear is first built in the house by parents, by, you know, maybe anybody, you know, grandparents. So the first thing is, like Manish was saying, it's the home. We need to make them realize that jo bhi ho, hum se keh sakte hain. And you don't need to be scared about anything. So that fear, that kuch hua, to beta, come and run and tell me. So it was very interesting how the teachers so beautifully said small things to a 5-year-old. I was shocked, you know. I said, what are you going to tell them? You know, because I didn't know how to say. So then now, I mean, I can see the confidence with which the Montessori children just say, don't touch me. You know, and it's like, you know, if anybody, if my friend Alphonse is here, you know, even if somebody comes and does this to her, she says, don't. You know, so pehle as public, पब्लिक जगह में जब हम किसी बच्चे को नहीं जानते हैं, डोंट गो एंड डू दिस, डोंट लिफ्ट, डोंट डू दैट, यू नो, दे डोंट लाइक इट. अगर किसी कोई हमसे ऐसे करे तो, यू नो, वी डोंट लाइक इट, वी डोंट लाइक. डू यू लाइक पीपल डूइंग दिस टू यू ऑल द टाइम? नो, यू डोंट. इवन अ चाइल्ड डजंट लाइक इट. सो लेट्स स्टॉप दीज थिंग्स, यू नो. सो वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट as adults, as parents, grandparents, as people who interact with children, as institutes, as teachers. So it all starts with us. And, you know, then the rest, law and everything is all later. But We need to start that.
On that beautiful note, Mr. Mahajan, I'd like to request you to join Usha ji to felicitate Anaya, please. Can you? Thank you. Usha ji, aap sabko thank you again.